Hello, I am your host, The Hidden One, and let's get right back into another video. Before we begin, please make sure to like and subscribe for more videos like this. In recent days, a certain Alex Hutchinson, former creative director of Assassin's Creed 3, and now creative director of Journey to the Savage Planet, and most notably, the creative director at the Montreal studio of Stadia Games and Entertainment, has come out on Twitter with the following controversial statement. Streamers worried about getting their content pulled because they used music they didn't pay for should be more worried by the fact that they're streaming games they didn't pay for as well. It's all gone as soon as publishers decide to enforce it. He then went on to say, "The real truth is, the streamers should be paying the developers and publishers of the games they stream. They should be buying a license, like any real business, and paying for the content they use." Now, I want to make absolutely clear that I do not support his take on licensed streaming of video games. I think that in a way, the relationship between video game publishers and streamers is symbiotic. For example, if a streamer is playing a little-known video game in front of their audience, it may make their audience want to play the game themselves, which in turn would financially benefit the publisher and game developers, at the same time as benefiting the streamer. Google, who itself has realised the benefits of streaming, released a statement as a result of Alex's recent tweets. They said, "The recent tweets by Alex Hutchinson, creative director at the Montreal studio of Stadia Games and Entertainment, do not reflect those of Stadia, YouTube, or Google." However, it would be wrong of me to not point out that Alex is absolutely right when it comes to the law. Streamers often don't have any legal right to stream a video game, and the assets found in said video games are usually protected under copyright law. However, many game developers and publishers ignore this because they have realised how beneficial streamers are for promoting their video games. EA, who is notoriously known for its greedy business practices, is actually in the right here, and they've realised the power of Twitch. When they released Apex Legends, they did this silently on Twitch, without any warning. This marketing tactic is credited to have got the game 2.5 million players within the first 24 hours of release, and 25 million players within the very first week. And it's not just EA. Forbes acknowledged in an article on the popularity of Fortnite in 2018 that Twitch streamers such as Ninja were particularly responsible for making Fortnite reach a wider audience, and Epic Games made exclusive deals with Twitch to get more players both playing the game and watching streams. It should be pointed out that there are always going to be negatives with any setup, including the current one. However, I don't think that game publishers should penalise the individuals, and instead should work closer with streaming platforms such as Twitch and YouTube to make streaming fair for everyone. What's your thoughts on this? Should streamers pay a licence to stream video games? Should things stay the way they are? Let me know in the comments down below. If you've enjoyed this video, then please make sure to like and subscribe. I have been your host, The Hidden One. And I'll see you in the next one.